morning, everybody, and welcome to another terrific Tuesday, October 26, 2021, episode 519. Today we're going to be talking from the Days of Praise book. We're going to be talking from, we're going to be talking about when Christ ascended, beginning with Ephesians 4, 8, and 9. If you're excited about another terrific Tuesday, smash that like button. Comment what you like, what you have liked about certain. If there's been a video that you like, comment what video that was. And I should go back and check and go back and hit the like button on that one. And then come back and comment what you liked about it. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, click the notification bell, and share the video and channel with your family and friends. And help me reach that 1,000 subscriber mark by the 1st of January. If you do that, I'd be much appreciated. But without further ado, when Christ ascended is your Days of Praise passage. Ephesians 4, 8, and 9. Wherefore he saith, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? Those are in parentheses. From now until earth. It's in parentheses. So this verse has been very controversial, but is nonetheless very important. The context is taken from Psalms 68, verses 17 through 20. The chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of angels. Thou hast ascended on high, thou hast led captivity captive. Our God is the God of salvation, and unto God the Lord belongs the issues of death. So the psalmist is apparently describing the Lord among his heavenly host, riding home as a mighty king returning to the spoils of battle. Evidently this battle prize consisted of his own people who had been held captive in an alien land, but who now have been captured from the enemy by the returning king. So to do this, the king, who is none other than the Lord Jesus himself, ascended up on high, leading them to his own throne in the heavens. But first he had to descend to the earth, and then even the lower parts of the earth. This unusual phrase must refer to the great pit in the center of the earth confining the souls of the dead, the place called Hades, or hell. So one of Christ's purposes on earth was to proclaim liberty to captive to the captives and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Isaiah 61 verse 1. That is exactly what he did when he died on the cross for the sins of those very captives, then in the spirit descended into Hades to set them free. He returned with the very keys of hell and of death, Revelation 1:18, alive forevermore. The souls of those who have died in faith came with him, finally ascending to him into paradise in the third heaven. Note Luke 23:43. In 2 Corinthians 12:2 and 4, to wait with him for his future return to reclaim the whole earth. Amen? Ooh, that's a little quick one. I used to take about 5 minutes for that one, but that was short. That was a short and sweet. Boom, boom, boom. Didn't ponder on that. I didn't start discussing something on that one, or it didn't feel like it needed it to. So, but I'm trying to hurry up. My battery's running a little lower than what I thought it would by the time I got to this video, so I still got one other video to make, so I'm trying to not trying to rush, I'm just trying to rush it a little bit. I don't ramble too long. So your daily bread passage set apart from Asiri Fernando is A-S-I-R-I, Asiri. I guess that's how you say pronounce it. But we're going to be talking from Romans 1, 1 through 6. And verse 1 says, Paul was set apart for the gospel of God. So Asiri writes, the three-wheeled taxis of Sri Lanka, known as tuk-tuks, are a convenient and delightful mode of transport for many. Lorraine, who is a resident of the capital of Colombia, also realized that they are a mission field. Hopping onto a tuk-tuk one day, she found a friendly driver more than happy to engage in conversation about religion. So the next time she told herself she would talk to the driver about the good news. So the book of Romans starts with Paul declaring himself as set apart for the gospel of God, as we've read Romans 1:1. And the Greek word for gospel is evangelion. It's evangelion. Like E-V-A-N-G-E-L-I-O-N. Leon. Evangelion. Which means good news. And Paul was essentially saying that his main purpose was to tell God's good news. So what is this good news, you may ask? Romans 1:3 says that the gospel of God is regarding his son. The good news is Jesus. The God who wants to tell the world that Jesus came to save us from the sin and death, he's chosen us to be his mode of communication. And what a humbling flag. So sharing the good news is the privilege of all believers in Jesus have been given. We've received grace to call others to his faith, verses 5 and 6. And God has set us apart to carry the exciting news of the gospel to those around us, whether on tuk-tuks or wherever we are. Like here on YouTube, that's what I'm doing. Like Lorraine, look for the opportunities in your daily lives to tell others the good news that is Jesus. Amen? So what barriers do you experience in sharing your faith? And what talents or interests can you use to present the good news? Well, I can go ahead and answer a true fact to myself. I can answer somewhat of a fact about the way I do it. It's YouTube. That's the way I'm sharing the good news. I'm recording these videos, reading the devotions, posting them on YouTube. If people watch them, they watch them. If they don't, they don't. And they're there when people are getting ready to watch it. If it's a good subject that they want to learn about, watch the video. That's all I can say. But that's something for you to ponder. And one way of pondering this, say this prayer. Jesus, thank you for making me your mouthpiece for your good news. May your spirit give me the courage and love to share about you today. Just say that and you'll be all right. Your Bible reading is Jeremiah 9, chapters 9 through 11, and 1 Timothy chapter 6. So, coming up later in your... Wait a minute, I forgot to get... Where's Timothy? Second Timothy 3. Okay. Got it right to the page. Tonight's Turning Point Devo for Tuesday, October 26th, in episode 75, we're going to be talking about mother apparel. Beginning with 2 Timothy 3, verse 1 and 2. Which we'll read that in the recommended reading of 2 Timothy 3, 1 through 9. And your turning point is from Matthew Henry. And your daily reading is Luke 11 and 12. Like I said the other day, we're going to be in Luke for the rest of the month. I don't know when it's going to change over. I haven't sent in the request to get the new book. I need to hurry up and do it. I need to go through on Monday and find out how to get it put through to get the book sent to me by the end of the week. I wish there was an 800 number I can call and ask a question. If I put it through now, can it get to me by the weekend? Because a week from today is, actually, yeah, week from today is the 1st. Because the 31st is on Sunday, so the 1st is on Monday. So I need to have it by the weekend so it can be set up ready to go. If I don't, I'll just do what I did with my Days of Praise book and put a few of them together so I could catch up. So I could catch the story up. So but you wouldn't have to worry about the Bible reading if I still say the Bible reading in it. So, but quit rambling. So with that said, I love you and I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your terrific Tuesday. Come back again tonight for your Tuesday Turning Point. See you then. Goodbye.